Hello. Welcome back once again, lovely people, to Jeff Finnegan's Wake. I'm Jeff. I'm reading to you one page of the James Joyce novel, Finnegan's Wake, one page at a time, one day at a time. Published 1939. Blah, blah, blah. It's a bunch of stuff I say, but I'm just knocking this one out real quick because we're on page 22. And yeah. All right, here we go. The dummy in their first infancy were below the tear sheet, ringing and coughing, like Broder and Histher. And the prank queen nipped a paley one and lit up again, and red cocks flew, flackering from the hill combs. And she made her witter before the wicked, saying, "Mark the twy, why do I am a look alike, two posse of porter peas, and shut," says the wicked, hand-wording her magistry. And so her majesty, aforethought, set down a jiminy, and took up a jiminy, and all the little pathways to woman's land, and she rain, and Jarve on Hoothers bleathered at her with a loud fingale. "Stop, Dom, comb, stop, come back, with my earring stop." But the prank queen swarreted, and liking it. And there was a wild old granuaile, that Laurency night of star shooting somewhere in Aereo, and the prank queen went for her 40 years walk in Tourmaline, and she punched the curses of Crom Cruel with the nail of a tip into the jiminy, and she had her four larksical monatricks to touch him his tears, and she provorted him to the one certain all secure, and he became a Tristane. So then she started raining, and in a pair of changers, B. Tomter, she was back again at Jarl von Hoother's and the Larry Hill, with her under her abramet. And why would she halt at all, if not by the ward of his mansion home, of another nice lace for the third charm? And Jarl von Hoother had his hurricane hips up to his pantry box, ruminating in his hold four stomachs, dare, oh dare, and the Jiminy tougher trees and the dummy were beloved on the watercloth, kissing and spitting, like roguing and poguing, like knave paltry and native naive bride, and in their second infancy. And the prank queen picked a blank and lit out, and the valleys lay twinkling. And she made her wittest in front of the archway of Trihump, asking, "Mark the trysts, why do I am a look alike, three posse of porter peas?" And that was how the skirmishes end up. For like the Campbells a-coming with a fork lance of lightning, Jarl von Hoother, Bonagers himself, the old terror of the dames, came hip-hop-handy-hap out of the pike-opened archway of his three shut-in castles, his broad ginger hat and his civic collar and his all-above hemmed and his bull-braggin socks and gloves and his lad-broke breeks and his cat-gut bandolier and his fur... something... We'll see you next time. This was page 22. Finnegan's Wake. Good night. My game finally downloaded. I'm going to go play it. No, I'm going to get a soda and then I'm going to go play it. Yeah.